Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Boy, the question that came in today is from another Bill, and Mike Gervin and I went around and around and around about this and finally decided there was only one good way to do it, and so it wasn't a dueling Excel podcast. We're going to talk about something called ASTM E29, which might also be known as banker's rounding, which I call Ron Luther rounding. Now, why do I call it Ron Luther rounding? Because, well, it was 10 or 15 years ago when a coworker of mine, Ron Luther, said, you know, Excel doesn't round correctly. I'm like, what do you mean it doesn't round correctly? He says, if you have a number like 45.5, Excel's always going to round the 0.5 up to 46. And I said, of course, that's the way we learned in school. That's how you round. 0.4 and below rounds down, 0.5 and above rounds up. He says, well, that's going to introduce errors. And I really just scoffed at Ron because, well, frankly, there was no good way to do this in Excel. But I got a note from Bill, another Bill, and he said, you know, we have to use this ASTM E29 rounding because it really does introduce errors. And so, finally I sat down and I said, alright, we're going to test this. We're going to see if it really introduces errors. And here I put in just a million, basically, cells that were ran between 100 and 999 divided by 10. So, I'm getting some decimals that are 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, and so on. And then, over here in column C, just use the regular round function in Excel, which, of course, is going to take all the 0.5s and round them up. So, then, I added up the total column of original numbers and the total column of rounded numbers. And, you know, the law of large numbers says that this all should round to basically the same thing. All right? But, sure enough, there is a bias there. It's $52,000 higher in the rounded column, which, you know, isn't huge, but it's a 0.09%, so 0.09 of a percent error that's being introduced. Now, Bill had introduced a possible formula, checks to see if the mod of the original number is equal exactly to 0.5, and if it is, then we're going to use mRound. mRound says, hey, we're going to round up to the nearest increment of 2. So, the rule here, and this is basically what Ron said, is every other number, you have to round either up or down. The ASTM E29 says, look, we're going to make a simple rule. If it's exactly 0.5, we're going to round to the even number. So, 0.5 rounds to 0, 1.5 rounds to 2, and that alternating rounding up or down for 0.5 will reduce the error. So, I copied that down and did the same test, added everything up, and sure enough, that error that was 52,000 is now only 572, and instead of being 0.09 of a percent, is, you know, incredibly small. So I said, all right, well, that's weird. It does actually make sense. If your rounding really matters, and you want it to round to basically the same number, it is important to do this. So using Bill's formula works for numbers that are rounding to an integer. Now, what's interesting is Microsoft claims that parts of Excel will conform to ASTM E29, but clearly not this function. You know, they don't have control over this. This function was written in the days of VisiCalc or Lotus, and Microsoft had to copy that functionality over so that way people's spreadsheets would work or when they switched from Lotus or VisiCalc up to Excel. I get that. They weren't in control. But what's really interesting is I'm going to switch over here to VBA, and in VBA there's a function called round, and this apparently is where the ASTM E29 is working, because if you round in VBA, well, sure enough, it rounds towards the even number when it is exactly 0.5. So here I use this little function called VBA round, and copy that down, and we get the exact same error. So, very interesting. You know, usually when we're rounding, I just always use round, comma, zero, and I figure it's close enough. But in fact, if you're really worried about this over a large data set, there are certainly other ways to go. Either the custom function here in VBA, the VBA round, or using this if function that Bill sent in. Now, of course, the inherent problem with this is the round function in Excel will allow you to specify comma 1, comma 2, comma 3, you know, to specify that we're going to tens, hundreds, or thousands. But it also lets you specify negative 1, which says round to tens, and the round function in VBA cannot handle rounding to negative digits. So you're going to run into a problem there. You're going to have to rewrite this formula to round to the right precision. And if you needed a function that would round to any precision, kind of like the round function in Excel, you're going to have a horrendous formula. And probably at that point, it's best to go over and create a UDF. The UDF, of course, for if you're rounding to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 decimal places, go ahead and use the round function. But otherwise, if you need to round to tens or hundreds or thousands, and you're worried about this, being able to round up to the other area, you're going to have to come up with your own algorithm. So there you have it, a very esoteric but really interesting discussion about rounding. When I first heard this, again, 15 years ago from my buddy Ron, I was like, oh, Ron, this can't possibly matter. But when you actually look, it does introduce quite a bit of error having that 0.5 always round up like we were in taught in school. Well, hey, there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.